परों को खोल जमाना उड़ान देखता है, जमीन पर बैठ के क्या आसमान देखता है। उसे गुमा है कि मेरी उड़ान कुछ कम है, मुझे यकीन है कि यह आसमां कुछ कम है। विद दीज वर्ड्स आई वेलकम आर ऑनरेबल गेस्ट फॉर टुडे एंड ऑल द डिग्निटरीज एंड आर कॉलेज एसोसिएट्स हु हैव जॉइंड अस टुडे टू एम्बार्क अ ग्लोरियस इवेंट बाय हंसराज कॉलेज यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली।
विद दिस वी विश यू अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम यू टू द इनॉग्रल एपिसोड ऑफ द एनुअल लेक्चर सीरीज अभिज्ञान अंडर द एम्बिट ऑफ आर फ्लैगशिप इवेंट अतुल्य। आई जानवी रानी, अ फाइनल ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ हंसराज कॉलेज एंड ऑल्सो द जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी ऑफ निष्ठा,
एंड डॉक्टर श्रेया मलिक, अ फैकल्टी एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हिस्ट्री हंसराज कॉलेज,
फील प्रिविलेज टू वेलकम आर गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर डॉक्टर सुब्रमण्यम जयशंकर सर, द एक्सटर्नल मिनिस्टर ऑफ भारत, आर एस्टीम प्रिंसिपल प्रोफेसर रमा मैम, कन्वीनर डॉक्टर प्रभांशु ओझा सर, एंड आर मोस्ट अवेटेड ऑडियंस।
वी वुड लाइक आर चीफ गेस्ट डॉक्टर एस जयशंकर सर, our honorable principal ma'am professor rama ma'am and other dignitaries on the dais present today to please move towards the deep prajwalan
अस्तु मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मामृतं गमय ॐ शान्ति 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 ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति।
हंसराज कॉलेज वॉज फाउंडेड बाय द डीएवी कॉलेज मैनेजिंग कमिटी ऑन 22 जुलाई 1948 इन द सीक्रेट मेमोरीज ऑफ महात्मा हंसराज जी एंड महर्षि दयानंद सरस्वती जी हु स्पेंड देयर मैग्निफिसेंट लाइव्स एम्फसाइजिंग द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ नॉलेज। इट इज़ वन ऑफ द लीडिंग लाइट्स इन द डीएवी फैमिली ओवर हैविंग ओवर 700 इंस्टीट्यूशंस। हंसराज कॉलेज इज द प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूशंस डेडिकेटेड टू टीचिंग एंड रिसर्च। It has highly qualified academicians who impart education in science, commerce, and arts at undergraduate and graduate levels for more than 5,000 students. The college has consistently demonstrated outstanding performance in academics, sports, and extracurricular performance and has completed 75 years in the realm of imparting higher education. It has made significant and unparalleled contribution in terms of producing scholars, bureaucrats, intellectuals, and sportspersons serving in different domains, not only in our own country, but even at the international level. With immense pride, I want to say that our college is moving towards the right direction, outgrowing not only academics, but various other fields. We have recently also celebrated our Diamond Jubilee, embarking our college to attain even more heights.
With the motto of Nishtha Dhriti Satyam, Nishtha has invariably relished every possible facet to aid the aspirants in their preparations and guide them in the best possible way. From organizing speaker sessions to providing materials through all the possible means, our team has worked much harder to deliver the content and information to the aspiring students. I would now like to take a moment to appreciate all the people who have shown so much of support to Nishtha till date and being the unwavering motivation for us to organize such events. Also, I would now request Sir Anjali to come up on the stage for the DAV Gaan. I request everyone to please stand up.
Aviral nirmal salil sadai ज्ञान प्रदायनी ज्योतिर्मय हो चहु दिशि उद्घोष अभय डीएवी जय जय डीएवी जय जय। प्रबल प्रवाह मई नित नूतन जीवन दायनी सदा सनातन वेद प्रणीता परम पुनीता ये धारा अक्षय डीएवी जय। से प्रेम भक्ति ले, हंसराज से त्याग शक्ति ले, धर्म भक्ति का राष्ट्र शक्ति का हो दिन मान उदय। डीएवी जय जय, सुख समृद्धि इसकी लहरे, प्रेम शांति इसके तट ठहरे, सघन शांतिमय प्रबल कांतिमय लिए अटल निश्चय। डीएवी जय जय, डीएवी जय जय।
Everyone, please settle down. I request our beloved Principal Ma'am, Vice Principal Professor Vijay Rani Rajpal Ma'am, Convener Dr. Prabhanshu Oja Sir, Alka Ma'am, Shalu Ma'am, and our President of Nishtha Society, Ashwamedh Singh, to kindly felicitate our distinguished guest speaker with memento.
इसी के साथ मुझे आप सबको बताते हुए हर्ष और गौरव महसूस हो रहा है कि हमारे बीच एक हमारी कुशल लेखिका एवं प्रसिद्ध वक्तव्य हमारे बीच हमारी प्रिंसिपल मैम प्रोफेसर रमा जी, इनकी एक किताब जो कि राष्ट्रीय पुस्तक न्यास पर महात्मा हंसराज जी द्वारा उनके द्वारा लिखी गई, आज उसका भी विमोचन हमारे ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट के द्वारा किया जा रहा है।
एक बार करतल ध्वनि के साथ हमारे माननीय विदेश मंत्री जी का स्वागत करें। जिस तरह से उन्होंने भारत की विजय पताका, भारत का यशगान, भारत की ज्ञान परंपरा, पूरे विश्व में उन्होंने एक नई गति दे दी है, नई ऊर्जा दे दी है। हमारी ये करतल ध्वनियाँ कम से कम इस दिल्ली को तो गुंजायमान कर ही दें। एक वो आनंद नहीं आया, आप उनके आने की कितनी प्रतीक्षा कर रहे थे, ये इंतज़ार ये प्रतीक्षा आज हमारे लिए एक सपना पूरा होने जैसा है। आदरणीय सर, निश्चित रूप से हंसराज कॉलेज की इस गरिमामयी परंपरा में आपका आगमन हम सब के लिए एक ऐतिहासिक क्षण है। निष्ठा सोसाइटी जो सिविल सेवा की तैयारी कर रहे हैं विद्यार्थी, उनके लिए समर्पित एक सोसाइटी है सर, और हमें ये गर्व है कि आप भी सिविल सेवक रहे और भारत के राजदूत और ऐसी तमाम बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण भूमिकाओं में आपने भारत को एक नई ऊर्जा, नई गति प्रदान की। ये हम सब के लिए सर बहुत ही गर्व का विषय है। वो दो पंक्ति मुझे याद आती है आपको सुनने के बाद सर, कि हमने उनको इतना देखा जितना देखा जा सकता था, लेकिन फिर भी दो आंखों से कितना देखा जा सकता था। आपको जब सुनते हैं सर तो हमें ऐसा ही महसूस होता है, बस सुनते रहें सुनते रहें। दिनकर जी की वो पंक्ति है जब वो रश्मि रथी में लिखते हैं कि बांधने मुझे तू आया है, वो जब आप बोलते हैं सर वैश्विक मंचों पर तो हमें ऐसा ही एहसास होता है कि अब आप भारत सुनने वाला भारत नहीं है, कि बांधने मुझे तू आया है, जंजीर बड़ी क्या लाया है, ये देख गगन मुझ में लय है, ये देख पवन मुझ में लय है। तो आज का भारत नई लय से, नई ऊर्जा से, नई गति से युक्त है सर। माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी, माननीय विदेश मंत्री जी की एक सुंदर जोड़ी है, वो हमारे युवाओं को, हमारी पूरी जनरेशन को सर नई ऊर्जा से संतृप्त कर रही है। सर बहुत ही हमारे लिए हर्ष का विषय है, गर्व का विषय है कि आपने विद्यार्थियों के उस निवेदन को स्वीकार किया और 75वें वर्ष को हंसराज कॉलेज के आपने और महनीय बना दिया। सर आज के इस विशेष अवसर पर हमें यह भी गर्व है कि आदरणीय विदेश मंत्री जी को महात्मा हंसराज गौरव सम्मान से सम्मानित किया गया है। एक बार इसलिए भी जोरदार करतल ध्वनि के साथ उनका अभिनंदन कर दें। यहाँ पर हमारे सभी श्रेष्ठ अध्यापक वृंद बैठे हुए हैं, हमारे एलुमनाइज आए हुए हैं सर विशेष रूप से आपको सुनने के लिए, मैं सबका हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं। मैं विशेष धन्यवाद देता हूं हंसराज कॉलेज की यशस्वी प्राचार्य प्रोफेसर रमा मैम को, एक बार उनके लिए जोरदार तालियां बजाएं। अभी उनकी पुस्तक का विमोचन हुआ है, महात्मा हंसराज जी जिन्होंने अपना पूरा जीवन शिक्षा को समर्पित किया, उनके जीवन पर उनकी पुस्तक आई है। रमा मैम बहुत ही कुशल लेखिका हैं, कुशल वक्ता हैं और सर भी दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी के विद्यार्थी रहे हैं। मैं सर के भी जानकारी के लिए बता दूं कि वो रमा मैम ने सर 1000 से अधिक डिबेट कंपटीशन जीते दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी में और देश भर में। तो हमारे कॉलेज को भी सर एक सशक्त नेतृत्व प्राप्त हो रहा है। ये तभी हो रहा है जब आप जैसे माननीय विदेश मंत्री, माननीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी हमारे प्रधानमंत्री, तो निश्चित रूप से आपका भारत एक नया भारत है। मैं इन्हीं बातों के साथ अपनी बात समाप्त करता हूँ, अश्वमेघ को विशेष आभार करता हूँ, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
आप सभी को सादर नमस्ते। आज का ये विशेष आयोजन निष्ठा सोसाइटी के द्वारा और इस आयोजन के मुझे लगता है पूरे राष्ट्र के, पूरे भारत के कोई अगर रोल मॉडल हैं तो वो हैं इस राष्ट्र के विदेश मंत्री आदरणीय श्री जयशंकर जी। श्री एस जयशंकर जी जिन्होंने सेंट स्टीफंस कॉलेज से केमिस्ट्री ऑनर से उन्होंने शिक्षा प्राप्त की। सेंट स्टीफंस कॉलेज में पढ़ रहे थे सर आप, उसके बाद विधाता ने तय किया हुआ था कि भारत जिस समय 21वीं सदी में जाकर अनेक चुनौतियों का सामना करेगा और इस राष्ट्र को एक बहुत अच्छे सक्रिय विदेश मंत्री की आवश्यकता होगी, इसलिए आपने उसके बाद जेएनयू में जाकर अपना अध्ययन किया। और जो आपका परिवार था, आपका परिवार था जो कि राजनीतिक परिवार था, लेकिन आपकी माता जो सामाजिक कार्यों के लिए लगातार जुड़ी रहती हैं, उन्हीं माता पिता ने जयशंकर को एक अलग सांचे में ढाला और आज जिस सांचे में उन्होंने ढाला था वो विदेश मंत्री हंसराज कॉलेज के मंच पर है। सर, हंसराज कॉलेज आज आपका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता है, आपके प्रति आभार व्यक्त करता है। मेरी आप सबसे करबद्ध प्रार्थना है, हम सबके रोल मॉडल हैं क्योंकि हंसराज आने से पूर्व दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय में जा चुके हैं, हंसराज में आने से पूर्व दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय के दूसरे कॉलेजेस में जा चुके हैं, लेकिन आज आप खड़े होकर तालियों के द्वारा उनका ऐसा स्वागत करेंगे कि ताउम्र उनको हंसराज कॉलेज की ये तालियां याद रहेंगी। आदरणीय, आज आपको सब सुनना चाहते हैं लेकिन मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगी कि जिस समय 1947 में भारत आज़ाद होता है, विदेशी जंजीरों से मुक्त होता है, उस समय आपको शायद ज्ञात होगा दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय में सेंट स्टीफंस कॉलेज की स्थापना हो चुकी होती है, हिंदू कॉलेज की स्थापना हो चुकी होती है, रामदास कॉलेज की स्थापना हो चुकी होती है और देश के सामने एक प्रश्न चिन्ह होता है। हो सकता है आने वाले समय में भारत अपने वसुधैव कुटुंबकम की भावना से, अपने मानवीय मूल्यों की भावना से हो सकता है कहीं विमुख हो जाए, उस समय कौन सी शैक्षिक संस्था भारत को संभालेगी। तो 1947 के बाद 1948 में दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय में हंसराज की स्थापना होती है। उस 1948 से लेकर अब जब देश 75 वर्ष पूरे करता है, हंसराज कॉलेज भी 75 वर्ष पूरे करता है, उस 75 वर्ष की आप सबको बहुत बहुत बधाई। 75 वर्ष की उपलब्धि है कि आज आदरणीय विदेश मंत्री हमारे बीच में हैं और जिस समय पूरी मैं देख रही थी जो उनके चलने की बॉडी लैंग्वेज है, जिस गति से चलते हैं, जिस विजन से सोचते हैं और जिस तरह से वो काम करते हैं, मैं उस समय कहती हूँ वसुधा का नेता कौन हुआ, आदरणीय वसुधा का नेता कौन हुआ, भूखंड विजेता कौन हुआ, अतुलित यश क्रेता कौन हुआ, नव धर्म प्रवेश कौन हुआ, नव धर्म प्रणेता कौन हुआ, जिसने ना कभी आराम किया, जिसने ना कभी आराम किया, विघ्नों में रहकर काम किया। विघ्नों में रहकर काम करना, चुनौतियों का सामना करना, और जिस तरह से विदेशियों को चुनौती देते हैं, जिस तरह से अमेरिका को जवाब देते हैं, चाइना को जवाब देते हैं, मुझे उस समय पंक्तियां याद आती हैं, मानो मन ही मन कह रहे हो कि भारत ने हर बात पे समझौता करना छोड़ दिया, अब हमने बापू गांधी बनना छोड़ दिया। सर सही में जिस कूटनीति द्वारा आज भारत पूरे विश्व में परचम फैला रहा है, ये देश सौभाग्यशाली है, पूरा राष्ट्र सौभाग्यशाली है कि माननीय आदरणीय मोदी जी इस राष्ट्र के प्रधानमंत्री हैं, लेकिन ये देश फिर सौभाग्यशाली है कि देश के पास जयशंकर जी जैसा विदेश मंत्री है। मुझे लगता है हमारे विद्यार्थी हमारे प्राध्यापक आज इस सभागार में बैठा हुआ एक एक व्यक्ति सौभाग्यशाली होगा, और मैं भी इस मौके पर एक अनुरोध करना चाहूँगी कि आज ये ऑडिटोरियम हमारे लिए छोटा पड़ गया, हम कोशिश करेंगे हंसराज कॉलेज के ग्राउंड में फिर से जयशंकर जी को बुलाएंगे और पूरे कॉलेज को सुनाएंगे। आप सब ने चुनाव में वोट देना आपका कर्तव्य है, और मुझे लगता है केवल दो पंक्तियों के माध्यम से, क्योंकि आप उनके साथ संवाद करना चाहते हैं, इसलिए केवल दो पंक्तियों के माध्यम से मैं उनके पूरे व्यक्तित्व को यदि आपके सामने प्रस्तुत करना चाहूं, तो मुझे लगता है वे केवल दो पंक्तियां वही हो सकती हैं। आदरणीय, कांटों से गुजर जाता हूं दामन को बचाकर, कांटों से गुजर जाता हूं दामन को बचाकर, फूलों की सियासत से मैं बेगाना भी नहीं हूं, मैं बेगाना। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Thank you, ma'am, for these powerful words. Now, finally, the time has arrived for the one we are waiting for and here for. Everyone, please hold your breath and welcome our notable guest speaker, a man of diplomacy, a man of Bharat, a man of New India, none other than Dr. Subramanian Jaishankar, sir. Please give a round of big applause for him. Sir.
Principal Professor Dr. Ramaji, Dr. Ojha ji, President Nishtha, Ashwamedh Singh ji, Mitron, Mera Sabko Namaskar. Aap log jante hain, normally ministers, politicians speak in many places. I have done so. But I think this was the most powerful introduction I've ever had. So I have today to try and live up to it. Now, before I speak to you about Viksit Bharat, I want to say a few words because the person standing before you is a student of Delhi University. Multiple generations. My mother was also a student of Delhi University, Indraprastha College ke alumnus. And I know, having studied in Delhi University, I know the importance, the significance of Hansraj College. In fact, all of us know that post-independence, this college, the establishment of this college had a particular significance. And in fact, I asked the principal, which is the biggest college in Delhi University. I just wanted to make sure that it was still your college. I was also a civil service aspirant, a successful aspirant. But I want to say, because I remember the times when we were preparing for the exam. And I can feel and still sympathize with the tensions and the concerns and the worries of people who are preparing for it. And I think some of you who have passed the exam recently know what I'm talking about. So even those who have successfully cleared, they should never forget what that period of preparation is, and they should make different efforts to be helpful. So when I had an opportunity, when I got this invitation to join people who are also focused on civil service aspirations, I felt a great desire to actually meet all of you and talk to you. Now, having said that, we all know these are very exciting times. There is a lot of excitable people who are having big debates in the country right now. And the issue right now, all our minds are looking at, is about our future. Now, people normally think of future माने अगले महीने, अगले साल, पांच साल, दस साल हो सकता है. I want today to talk to you about the next 25 years. The next 25 years, which is your future, which we know as our Amrit Kaal, which will be the journey, our yatra to Viksit Bharat will be in these 25 years, and you are the people who are going to make that journey. Now, in recent times, there has been a lot of talk about Viksit Bharat, and I want to tell you very frankly, please don't think it is a slogan. It is not something which is said to prochahit karne ke liye nahi hai. It is something very serious we are talking about. And the reason why today we speak about Viksit Bharat with great confidence is in the last 10 years, we have actually created a foundation. A foundation from which this country and your generation will actually move towards Viksit Bharat. I can tell you, as someone who watches the world, who deals with the world, and who has seen other countries. I've lived in other countries, you know, I've lived in America, Japan, Russia, China. I can feel today that we are actually at the point of something very big. And that, you know, that sense that how do we achieve, how do we prepare for this journey of 25 years, that is really what all of you should focus on. Now, I also want to tell you that hamari aapas mein debates hoti rahengi, that is natural, it is nature of democracy also. There will be choices, but the right now, the world is also watching us. The world is looking to see how is this country, with this foundation of 10 years, how are they going to really accelerate and make this journey of 25 years. And I see this 25 years as a period of new opportunities, as a period of new technologies, but also, I must tell you, a period of new challenges. It will actually be a very different era. That what we today read about, these will become realities in the next few years. That artificial intelligence in maximum 5 years will change the way our lives are. That, you know, I cannot even imagine what it would do, for example, to civil service preparation. That artificial intelligence, chips, the way electric vehicles, we are today actually talking of self-driven cars. We are looking at drones. Drones have become a reality. It used to be like something in a movie some years ago. Space, that what will be possible with the help of space? Not only space, actually when we talk of resource, deep seabed mining, that we think of resources being on land, but there will be resources which Today we only are guessing that they are there, but these will be accessible to us. And we will see, you know, green, clean technology. So in many ways, you know, world has always changed. But this time, this era, what you are all going to experience is change of a kind that we have never seen. And that is something that we need to prepare for. Now, I have given you the variable factors, but I also want to give you some numbers so that you understand how big this change will be. Today, we are a little bit less than $4 trillion economy. Okay. We expect in next few years to cross $5 trillion. When we do that, we will become the world's third largest economy. But, you know, by the time we reach, by the time we reach Amrit Kaal, we are confident of minimum being a 30 trillion economy. And in fact, there is a Goldman Sachs study to say that by the time you will all be younger than me, and we will be second, possibly, who knows, usually Indians are never happy being second. But we will definitely be the second largest economy, that we would be in excess, according to Goldman Sachs, of excess of $52.5 trillion economy. So if you just look at the numbers, look at the scale of change, look at the kind of things. I mean, this ChatGPT that you have all seen, this is the first smallest trailer you are seeing. You know, the first computer I ever used was 286. I laugh at it today. One day you'll be laughing at ChatGPT. That will be the kind of pace of change that all of you are going to see. Now, I told you that the world is watching us today. The world is watching us, saying, okay, how is this country? This country, for long, which people underestimated, which had its own problems, which had a very difficult period during colonial rule, but now has come back. How will this country today rise? How will it impact the world? And it cannot be done only by promises and slogans and saying, hamara potential hai, you know, one day we will do this. In real life, people look at performance. Even in college, you know, after all your teachers think every one of you has fantastic potential. But what do they judge you by? They judge you by your performance. So let us look from the eyes of the world. Suppose you are now having an assessment of India. What is it in the last few years which has impressed the world? I would say today, probably for the world, the most important thing is that we are today the fastest growing large economy of the world, that we are growing at 7%, that 10 years ago we were seen as a fragile 5 economy, pata nahi in logon ko kya ho jayega, kahin ludak jayenge. But today we are actually a cause of hope, and we are seen actually among the top 5 economies, as I said, likely to be the third. This the world, because see, the world is very objective. The world judges things very, very much by very objective criteria. They may like you, but if you do not perform well, they may like you, but they may not respect you. Today, if we are to be respected, and we are respected, I would say one of the main reasons for it today is our economic performance. And not just what it has done. The world knows that what we are now seeing is not for next term or next few years. We have at least 30 to 40 years of very solid growth. Through your entire lifetime, we will be growing. You know, your generation is going to see through your entire lives a degree of continuous growth, which no Indian has seen for 300, 400 years. So please understand, you know, what is the positioning today of the economy? The second, and this is again, you know, like human beings. If somebody has been through a very difficult period, यू वॉन्ट टू सी. अच्छा, वो एक किस्म से स्ट्रेस टेस्ट हो जाता है. हाउ डिड दे गो थ्रू दैट टेस्ट? एंड द बिगेस्ट स्ट्रेस टेस्ट द वर्ल्ड हैज़ गॉन थ्रू इज कोविड. कोविड is known as a once in century challenge, because last time something like this happened was 100 years ago, something called Spanish flu. Now people looked at how India did during COVID. We were among the countries initially in the beginning of 2020, the world, and this is not a speculation, I have myself experienced it firsthand. In 2020, when world leaders first met, एक virtual meeting थी G20 के नेताओं की. And the main, you know, they discussed कि COVID को रोकना मुश्किल है, it will come, we can't stop it, इसमें going to be tremendous losses. And the general sense of the meeting was, if there is one country which will not have the ability to deal with COVID, that is India. That is where it began, January 2020. I myself heard it sitting behind Modi ji. Now, where we began and what we saw in the next 2 years, the same country they worried about, that this country cannot cope. And the reasons for worry was genuine, because if you looked at our health situation, health preparation, you looked at our manufacturing, you looked at our economy, there was good reason for them to worry about. But that same country produced the mask, it produced the PPE, it produced the ventilator, it produced the medicine, it produced finally the vaccine. And that country with which the world worried about ended up supplying 100 countries with their vaccines. Now, let me tell you, you know, COVID has passed. Mane itna bura samay tha, all of us like to forget it. Okay, it's. But there are people still, I go around the world, completely unknown people walk, they will hold your hand, they will come and thank you, they will say, if it was not for India, we would have never got vaccine. So they look at our performance, but they also saw what the global impact was. The third factor, which is very much in the mind of the world today, is actually digital. That, you know, they look, okay, everybody in the world is digital today. Okay, probably there are more phones than there are human beings in the world. And we all know our day begins and ends with the phone. So, but in digital, they look at how we have used digital. They could see it during COVID also, that we were one of the few countries which gave digital certificate. Baaki log jo hain, wo kagzi de rahe the. Even developed countries, even America was initially giving you a parchi. We were having it on the phone. Oh, woh yakin nahin karte the when they saw your phone. You know, they wanted to see your parchi, because they had not got used to somebody actually moving it to the digital level. But today, if you look at the range, you know, how digitized India has become. I mean, I don't know among all of you, how many of you today anymore use cash? How many of you today you use your phone-based cashless payments? Now, aap logon ko normal lagta hai. Duniya ko nahi lagta. And you know, to understand this, hum log jo hain in India, we do 10, 11, 12 billion cashless transactions per month. America does 4 billion in a year. Please, see the difference. Even China does, I think, maximum 20 billion in a year. So when it comes to payments, when it comes to delivery of services, you know, people today get, you know, their income tax faster, they get their housing allotments, they get driving licenses. Hamare department, we give passports so much faster. Why? Because we are actually doing digitally based governance. So the man, and most of all, what digital has done, digital actually has cut down corruption at the service level, because it is digitally recorded ki maine application kab diya, kitne din aapke paas the, aapke office se kahan gaya. So The moment you start tracking, the moment you actually get accountability with it. That with the transparency, other honesty also comes. So this image has come today of India as a very digital city. Now you can say, "Acha, that is a very technology-centric image, but aapki to purani problem thi, uska kya hua?" Now it's very interesting. You know, in the last 10 years, if you see, 250 million people have actually come out of the poverty level. It is the biggest poverty reduction that actually any country has done in this period. So if you look today, actually even at the traditional problems, jo duniya ke man mein hai, that you know they think of India, acha wahan bijli nahi hai, sadak nahi hai, gareeb log hain, ghar nahi hai. Today those problems are also getting done. And then they look at the infrastructure. You know, the same people who came to Delhi, ab aate hain pehle airport ki tareef karte hain. Then they say, "Acha, your highways have improved, your traffic has improved." They look at the facilities really today across the country. There is great scope for improvement. I'm not saying we are happy. I'm not saying our work is done. In fact, I say through your lifetime, you will keep improving it. But they look at our infrastructure. They see today that this is a country which is building almost 30 kilometers of national highway every day. That this is a country, you know, there are other countries where after you actually board airport in Delhi, if any of you go abroad, one thing I will guarantee you, in most countries you will be disappointed at the airport which you get down. Because you will ask yourself, "Arey, ye to bahut purane kisam ka airport hai, it reminds me of Delhi 20 years ago." So if you look actually today at the change, the growth of infrastructure, the modernization of infrastructure, the road, the rail, the air traffic, the facilities of various kinds. And then I think there is this sense that this is today a different India because of Make in India. That Make in India is actually making, is a way by which India is now producing its own products. And I think that also makes a very big difference. And finally, this is very much in the image of the, in the mind of the world, it is very much a sense that this is an India which is actually a technology leader. You know, the most impressive, if there is one thing you ask people in the world, India ke saath kuch, what is the first thought which comes to you? Today, most people in the world will say moon landing. That the impact which Chandrayaan 3 made on the thinking of the world, that was tremendous. And when we actually tell them the budget of Chandrayaan 3, you know, that what people are fond of saying, that Chandrayaan 3 went to the moon at less than the cost it takes to make a movie. You know. So if you look, you know, these kinds of things, that even your phone, you know, we imported our 2G, 3G, 4G technology. Those of you who have 5G technology on your phone, please realize it's the first time you actually have an India stack on your phone. Now, when you tell people, because remember, in the world today, 5G technology is only, it's made in China, it is made in Korea, and it's made in Europe. So people have this sense today that, okay, India has reached that level of technology that they are capable of this. So I want to sum it up by saying, in the perception of the world, India is dealing with the old problems, the traditional problems, but India is getting ready today, it is prepared today to be at the forefront of the new ones. Now, so far what I have told you is like the material aspect. Okay, main road ki baat kar raha hu, airport ki baat kar raha hu, technology ki baat kar raha hu. But the world is full of human beings. So they also say, what kind of people are they? Because when we speak about Viksit Bharat, the world will watch what is our behavior, what is the outlook of these people. I think today, probably more than ever before, at least in living memory, the talent of India The talent of India is actually today getting tremendous recognition. I just saw today in one of the newspapers, I was coming to the university, and I saw that there was a big article that there were now more Indian students in Germany than there were Chinese students. Now, why this was interesting was, in Germany, they go outside the country and search, you know, they recruit students and bring them to Germany. Now, in the past, they used to focus on China. Today, they're actually focusing on Indian students, which is why the numbers have gone up. Now, when I look back on foreign policy, I am finding, you know, through Australia, Austria, Italy, Japan, Portugal, France, the number of countries who want actually Indian talent, Indian skills to come to these countries. I'm leaving America out, unka to purana hai, wo saalon se chal raha hai. So this is one. But along with this, they also admire something else that we do. Because for many countries, people go out. It's natural, globalized dunya hai, passport hai, logon ke haath mein, airlines hai. But we are one of the few countries which say, if you are an Indian citizen, wherever you are, whatever situation you are in, we are there for you. And I can tell you, very, very few countries do. You know, a lot of you are very familiar with what happened during Operation Ganga in Ukraine. Perhaps not many of you know that many countries in the world told their people, bhai, you are in Ukraine, there's a war, it's your problem. Humne aapko kaha tha, please get out, aap nahi nikle, there is nothing we can do for you. Even developed countries, many of them, left their citizens, their students, their young people behind in Ukraine. Contrast that with us today. You know, it happened in Ukraine, it happened last year in Israel, uske pehle Sudan. Where we find our people in a problem, and this is very important, because our people going out have the security. And you know, it could be anybody, it could even be tourist. You know, when COVID happened, when COVID came and we did lockdown, lakhs of people were left outside the country. Again, many countries said, your problem. We actually ran flights to bring them back. And we did it on a scale which no other country has done. So our talent is going out, but side by side we are getting the reputation these people actually look after their people. And this is very important as we move towards Viksit Bharat, this image of India. We care for ourselves, but increasingly you will see, you will read some report, you know, Indian team went to Turkey, wahan earthquake hua. Indian team went to Mozambique, wahan floods hua. Indian team went to Sri Lanka or Kuwait. You know, during COVID, we sent our military teams out to help some countries because they didn't have doctors. So we actually sent military doctors out at that period. So this human factor of, you know, one is what is India doing, economy, politics, but other is what are Indians like? And this is also today very much shaping the perception of the world. And in this, our community which lives abroad is making a very big difference, because by their success and their achievements, they are actually very much creating the perception. Now, what then is the overall image of India? I would say today, the image of India is friendly, but the image of India is firm. कि जहाँ ज़रूरत है तो ये लोग हाथ बढ़ाते हैं, जहाँ इनको अड़ना है, they will definitely, they are capable of that. That is actually today the sense of India. If you look, for example, at a challenge like terrorism, the world recognizes today that today's India deals with terrorism very differently from how it used to. And it's a comparison very simple. People look at Mumbai attack 26/11. 26/11 ke samay mein kya hua? Ab kya ho raha? Uri Balakot ke samay mein kya hua? That's a comparison they make. Or they look, for example, we have a challenge in our China border. They look to see, okay, These people are standing up, they are sending the troops, they are staying firm. That also the burnouts. Or actually they look, you know, one example which all of you are familiar with. We came under pressure on Russian not buying oil from Russia. And people said, they saw in India which said, no, my interest of my people requires that I buy that oil and I'm not hiding it. You know, there were countries who unhone, I'm sorry to say this, cheating karke kahin se kharida hoga. We were very open about it. We were very honest about it. But we were very courageous about it. So this sense today that this is a firm country, but it is also a fair country. That during G20, where most people did not expect that there would be an agreement. उस दिन जिस दिन मीटिंग शुरू हुई किसी की अपेक्षा नहीं थी कि सर्वसहमति से कम्युनिके बनेगा एंड येट वी मैनेज इट एंड नॉट ओनली डिड वी मैनेज इट तो द लॉन्ग पेंडिंग डिमांड की अफ्रीका को उनकी सदस्यता जो थी इट वॉज पेंडिंग फॉर मैनी मैनी ईयर्स एवरीबडी वुड टेल अफ्रीका भाई वो कर देंगे देन से अच्छा नेक्स्ट गाय विल डू इट नाउ वी फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग वी आर वेरी क्लियर दैट वी विल डू इट And we will do it and we promised Africa, we will get it done in our time. So, this image of India today, being open to the world, being friendly to the world. So, if I were today to say this journey on Viksit Bharat, why is today the Foreign Minister of India putting so much focus on it? For this reason. The journey towards Viksit Bharat will actually bring us much closer to the world. In a globalized world, we will be working outside, more foreign businesses will be here, we will be dealing with more foreign factors. And in different ways, your lives will change. You know, you will all be traveling more, even as personal travel, as tourists you will be going more. So our connection with the world will grow. As we move towards Viksit Bharat. But the world can also be a big help to us. Because if the image of the world is that India is a good country, it's a law-abiding country, yahan contract ho to uski qadar karte hain, usko mante hain. If the sense is these are people easy to work with and they are, you know, it has a government or it has a system which is very much at ease with the world. I think this comfort with the world will actually make us go faster towards Viksit Bharat. So I actually believe that we must have a foreign policy which will prepare the way as we move towards Viksit Bharat, which will prepare for a global workplace. Today, you know, there are almost about little less than 2 crore Indians who live and work abroad, maybe about 1 crore plus who have taken citizenship of another country. But we will see these numbers grow. So we have to prepare the way for that. But most important, I would say, our economic contribution, our technology contribution, and our talent contribution. Because in many parts of the world, you are going to see big shortages of people. It is not only going to be in IT or in health. In every profession, actually, world is going to have shortage of lawyers, shortage of accountants, shortage of doctors. There is going to be a big demographic issue in the world. And we are, in this 25 years, we are actually at our peak performance. This is, in many ways, an opportunity. So, let me conclude it with this remark, that today, we are all busy with something very important, it's very understandable. We have also to show the world that democracies deliver, that democratic exercises produce results which are good for growth, which are good for development, which create a country which the rest of the world is very, very comfortable working with. That is why I believe today that the world is not only watching us. I think large parts of the world actually wish us well. That many people, you know, I was with Prime Minister when Chandrayaan landing took place. Hum log Africa mein the. And the sentiment in the room, there were about 40, 50 presidents and prime ministers. Most of them felt ये लैंडिंग जरूर आपका होगा बट गर्व जो है वी ऑल्सो फील द सेम अलॉन्ग विद सो आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर दैट सेंस विथ यू टूडे यू नो देर विल बी सम और पीपल हियर एंड देयर कोई पेपर में लिखेगा कोई यहीं आलोचना करेगा दैट इज नेचुरल दैट हैपन्स इन अ वर्ल्ड ऑफ मेनी ओपिनियंस बट वी इंडियंस टूडे शुड बी प्राउड ऑफ वॉट वी हैव अचीव्ड शुड बी एम्बिशियस अबाउट वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू डू वेयर वी वॉन्ट टू डू वी शुड बी कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट दिस जर्नी टुवर्ड्स विकसित भारत दैट वी आर एम्बार्किंग ऑन एंड दैट सेंस मोस्ट ऑफ ऑल मस्ट कम विथ यू बिकॉज एज आई सेड दैट नेक्स्ट पीरियड दैट 25 एंड द ईयर बियॉन्ड दैट इज योर एरा Our generation's responsibility is to create the foundation. That is the best we have done for you. But I'm very, very confident. I mean, whenever I look at the youth of India, I feel actually that, you know, the country has tremendous possibilities. And I think today for me, it was one more opportunity to reaffirm that sense. Once again, really, thank you very much for inviting me. And it's a pleasure to be here.
Now the forum is open for the question and answer round. So our volunteer would reach. Please raise your hand.
Good afternoon, sir. This sector. Sir, this is Vineet, a sophomore pursuing philosophy honors from Hansraj College. Sir, in the past few years, we have seen that India's cultural power has been increased significantly. So, sir, my question is that what role does India's cultural soft power have played in India's diplomatic initiative throughout the globe?
So we have seen that India came a long way from being recognized as a country of snake charmers and mices to now being able to evacuate thousands of NRIs and our beloved neighbors from war-stricken countries. Sir, how please throw some light on this quantum level of jump of India's stature at the global level.
Namaskar, sir. Sir, I'm Sakshi. I'm a student of English literature and I'm also aspiring to be an IFS officer. Sir, my question would be that India has reached a level where we are growing and developing positively. But my question would be that the situation with our neighborhood, as we have seen recently with Sri Lanka, China, Nepal, is not very good. So what would be our futuristic roadmap to tackle these situations for Viksit Bharat?
Thank you. So, first, I will take this question, then we can do one more round. The first question, cultural power can I I think it's very important for us to be conscious of our culture, to be proud of our culture, and to propagate our culture. I'll tell you why. There are, you know, if you look at the history of the world, of the old civilizations, very few of them are still today big nations. So most of the old civilizations, I would say we and China, in many ways, are the two big powers who are also old civilizations. That's a very special responsibility that we have. The second, you know, as we become bigger in the world, people want to know us, like I said, they want to understand us. Ki bhai, inka dimaag kaise chalta hai, inka DNA kya hai, inki soch kya hai, inka reaction kya hai. People, that's a very natural thing. Now, if we do not ourselves, we are not proud of ourselves, if we do not put our own tradition and culture and, you know, music and yoga and whatever, then how will the world know? If we are ourselves defensive about it, then, you know, the world is very, very, because that Odoso Sal, the colonial era, the world is actually very, very Western in its thinking and in its culture. Now, to do that, it is very important that we put our share, our viewpoint, you know, forward very strongly. So, we feel that it can be, you know, there was a reason why we started this International Day of Yoga. Yeah, it's very good for the health of the world and mental peace of the world. But it is also something which has made India, in, brought India into the consciousness of the world, and I think it's something which we need to keep doing. The second question, ek zamane mein people would say snake charmers hai, so how have you taken the job? I would say by a variety of steps. It didn't happen at one time. You know, I think this image, ye IT ka desh hai, Indians are techies, this was helpful for us. COVID ke samay mein, because we supplied so many vaccines, ab logon ko unke dimag mein ye idea baith gaya hai ki this is pharmacy of the world. Ki dawai chahiye to bhai ye Indians are good people to get it from. So bit by bit, today, you know, how to design in this country, how to innovate in this. That's why, you know, why Chandrayaan is important. Because now you are no longer back office of the world. You are actually front launch of the world. That there has to be constant demonstration of capability. So that world will understand that, okay, these people are capable of that. And the third question, the, you know, neighborhood. See, everybody, neighbors are inherited, you can't do anything about it. And we also have to accept that dunya mein competition hoti, that nobody is going to be nice to you automatically. They may not be your enemies, but there is no compulsion on people to be very helpful all the time. But sab log apna apna dekhenge, that is also natural. So we have to create a situation in the neighborhood where people, other neighboring countries in, to us say, if we are friends of India, there is a gain for us. If we are linked to India, there is a gain for us. And that is exactly what we are trying to do. You know, last year, there was a big problem in Sri Lanka. I mean, I went to Sri Lanka in the middle of it. I cannot tell you how bad it was. I mean, literally people, they were running short of food. Petrol nahi tha, bijli nahi tha. You know, and you know, it was terrible to watch what was happening to them. Now, rest of the world debated, karein, nahi karein, acha, chalo, let us get a full accounting of their debt. We made up our mind, okay, it's a neighbor, then big difficulty. Let us help them and let us help them decisively. So, everybody else was still talking. We moved. And I can tell you, Sri Lanka, you know, if you go to the average person, they would say, I know at that time who stood by us. Even people who have no history of positive association with India recognize that. Same thing if you go today to Bangladesh, you go to Nepal. You know, people remember, COVID ke samay mein unki vaccine kahan se aayi. Ye sabko pata hai. Ukraine युद्ध के समय में फर्टिलाइजर की शॉर्टेज थी, तेल की शॉर्टेज थी, कहाँ से? तो बट इट डजंट कम ऑटोमेटिकली ऑल्सो नो, तेल भेजना है तो पाइपलाइन क्रिएट करना पड़ता है, बिजली भेजना है तो ग्रिड बनाना पड़ता है, सामान भेजना है तो रोड होने चाहिए. तो वी हैव टू क्रिएट आई वुड से सिस्टम बाय विच द नेबरहुड इज वेरी क्लोज टू अस एंड इट इज नेचुरल. यू नो, China is just across the neighborhood, वो भी अपना कोशिश तो करें. तो तुम्हें I have every confidence, your generation will not be scared of competing. You know, we are capable of competing. I feel this country today has reached that level. I mean, whether it is in sports, whether it is in life, whether it is in politics or in economics, I think we have it in us. And the more we compete, actually the better, stronger we will.
Currently a second year economics on a student at Hansraj College. So my question is that while taking decisions on international matters, how do you try to strike a balance between ethics and humanity on one side and nationalist interests on the other side? Thank you, sir.
Namaste, sir. Myself, Laksh Amavar. And my question to you is that if you would be starting from zero, what would be the best advice that Dr. Jayashankar would give to his younger self?
Other than joining Hansraj College?
Namaste, sir. मेरा प्रश्न यह है कि आपके सबसे पसंदीदा प्रधानमंत्री और सबसे पसंदीदा विदेश मंत्री कौन है जिनसे आप प्रेरणा लेते हैं और जिनको आप देख के आगे बढ़ते हैं? धन्यवाद.
One mic has to go somewhere.
So my question is, what
Bharat have a unique press that is going to be the reason for its flourishment in the next 25 years?
So, जो पहले सवाल जो था कि how do you get a balance between ethics and ethics, humanity, national interest? देखिए, it is sometimes it can be an issue at times, but sometimes it is not also. It depends how you judge the ethics. I'll give you a very interesting situation. क्योंकि Ukraine का युद्ध जो शुरू हुआ, at that time, a lot of European Western countries told us, you know, you should not buy oil from Russia because aap Russia se lenge, then aap Russia ko paise denge, you are funding a war effort, and they say you are unethical. Ab, alag baat hai, wo khud apna, they were continuing to buy, they had reduced the buying, but they were also still buying. So naturally, I told them that, look, you are also buying, why are you coming and telling? But I will give you a very interesting ethical dimension of. These are countries who are at $50,000 per capita income. Okay, $50,000. They were not prepared to cut their own linkage because they felt among for their citizens it would be a big problem. And they are asking a country of $2,500 to take the sacrifices. So I told them, I said, look. Forget other things. Is it moral of you to even ask? I mean, is a poor Indian consumer, somebody, you know, for whose livelihood the petrol cost may actually destroy that person, should that person actually be paying a higher cost than a, you know, somebody who's 20-25 times their income in Europe? So sometimes even ethics, you know, people put ethics in a very different way than it could be. But there will be issues. At the end of the day, look, countries have their interests. Sometimes the interests make for very difficult decisions. You have to balance it. I would never say that you should disregard ethics. You know, I feel to be good and to be smart are not different things. You can be both. In fact, I would argue to be good is actually to be smart. Because people will remember what you do. They will repay what you want. That aapki brand improve ho jayegi. That is smart. So there are not choices to be good and to be smart. You know, and I feel if you look even during COVID, many people told us why are you sending out vaccines? Aap sabka vaccination yahan khatam nahi ho. But look at the goodwill it has earned us. And you know, I'll tell you a very interesting. Time. You remember Delta wave आया था ना? Delta wave के समय में हमारे यहाँ बहुत बड़ी oxygen की shortage थी. You know, at that time, एक महीना भी only did we were all our ministers we were put to work somehow find oxygen and bring it to the country. I tell you the best response I got for oxygen supply were from the Gulf countries because during COVID, we had kept the food supply going to them. We got it from Western countries, you know, countries like America, because we gave them medicine when they had the first wave of COVID. So you could see that our goodness brought some reward back to us. So I would say there are two sides in a way of the same coin. The advice which I have to give. Look, I give you a very simple thing I have learned in life. Because all of us will aspire to many things. Sometimes you will get something, sometimes you will not get something. Some will be lucky, some will be function of how much work you put. The only consistent thing I have learned is if you actually pursue what you like, what you really, your heart is in it, you know, it's really a strong interest for you. It is not there because, you know, your father, mother, teacher, somebody told you, ye aapko karna hi hai. That I accept that, you know, we listen to that. But if your heart is in something, you will do well. This I can tell you. And so I would tell people, because today you all have many more choices. You know, I mean, I'm very proud of the fact that I was in the government, I was in the foreign service. If people ask me, would you do it again? Yes, of course I would. But it is, I would also say that many of you also have many other options and choices when I look at the possibilities. So follow your interest, you know, follow your passion. I would say that would be my advice. That other question, Prime Minister, so I think you want me to think a little bit, I can still give you the same answer. So I think the answer is obvious, and you know that when you ask me. But I would only say this. As someone who was in government, who has no political history, agal bagal mein family mein koi nahi hai in politics. I tell people, only the current Prime Minister would have made me Foreign Minister, but I would have never entered politics were it not for this Prime Minister. The same happened, because my sense today of what is what he's trying to do for that country. To such a person, you cannot say a no when he asks. And when it comes to foreign ministers, again, you know, it's very interesting. I joined the Foreign Service when Atalji was actually the foreign minister. So I have seen since that period. But all them, and many of them are people I've known very personally, very deeply. Some, you know, one was even my boss in Foreign Service. But I would say to me, the one I remember most frequently, most, not really affectionately, but I would say in terms of the bond of working, was actually my predecessor, Shivnath. That what I learned from him, what I learned working with her about how, you know, you politically actually managed, because I was a secretary. And in government, you know, the minister secretary ki jodi jo banti na, that is actually determines how good any ministry is. That is, you know, because it's like a, I don't know, like a COO and a CEO, jo bhi aap kahe, you know. And I found that 3 years that I worked with her, and then of course I stayed with her in close touch even afterwards. So for me, actually, when I think of a foreign minister, she is immediately the person who comes to my mind. On the uniqueness issue, you know, it's very interesting. If we go around the world, most countries actually have one language. Even if there are other languages, most of them have one religion. Most of them often have a single ethnicity. They are standardized subject. We are very actually unique. Hamare yahan jo diversity jo hai, and the space that we give to each other, and the way we are able to, you know, accommodate each other and fit into each other, and then what comes up. So I actually believe somewhere that culturally, civilizationally, we have some inner confidence and belief in Bharat, which allows us to give space to different expressions of Bharat. And this is very difficult for the world to understand. But, you know, one of the interesting things I used to do when I was a diplomat, hum log jo hai hamara note le jaate currency note, and then currency note nikal ke we would show people how many languages the currency note has. You know, other countries, people are very, very impressed, they are very baffled by this, because very few countries, I mean, I in fact would really struggle to think which other country would have more than, there are one or two, which would have more than one language on its currency. So our, I think, this unity which allows this diversity to be expressed itself, that I think is something very, very unique about us. You know, as I said, for me, we are a 5,000-year civilization, and we should always have that sense, you know, the pride and confidence and the wisdom.
My name is Harshit Poddar. I am a final year student of economics. So I have been reading your book, The India Way, and I'd like to just ask one thing. This is one of the lines. This is a time for us to engage America, manage China, cultivate Europe, reassure Russia, bring Japan into play, draw neighbors in, and extend the neighborhood, and expand traditional constituencies of support. Sir, I would like to ask you, what's the context behind writing this line? The reason, because I feel this explains the full of the foreign relations of India with other countries.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, you are the best diplomat in the world ever have. How did you acknowledge that diplomacy? How did you deal, how did you know that diplomacy, how to deal with people? Putin just break his protocol to meet you, sir. How did you make that happen?
Sir, as we talk about the dominance of India, the power of India in today's times. So I want to ask you a question. Like for example, we have SAARC, the initiative. So more or less many countries around our region, they are stating that India as a power is a dominating factor in the current scenario, if you talk about the Indian subcontinent. So sir, what's your take on it? I mean, how you present India as not being dominated and being helpful and friendly in this environment? Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. I'm Shraddha, a first-year student pursuing philosophy honors. Sir, I'm really honored to be here. Sir, we all know that you are admired for the strong, assertive approaches that you are with. Sir, I want to know that how does Jai Shankar sir decide that when to go with the strong, assertive approaches and when to apply the soft approaches while presenting India's stance in the global arena?
Sorry, you have one of you at the last question. Yeah, go ahead.
Hello sir, my name is Aditya Kothari, pursuing BCom honors from Hansraj College. I am a first year student. Sir, if you were an architect of the world, how would you design the world map and which all countries will be the neighboring countries of India and which country will be the farthest?
Okay, the first question which I got, you know, which was a quote from my own book. You know, I was trying to summarize how we have to, you know, whether it is Russia, or America, or Europe, or China, or Japan, neighbors. So in a way, I tell people, ye sabka saath sabka vikas jo hai na ghar mein, you do it outside India. That if you more people, more countries you carry with you. I mean, ultimately, what is good diplomacy? Good diplomacy is maximum goodwill, minimum problems. That is what we are trying to do. So, my purpose of the quote which you read out was that this is actually what we want to do. And that's, you know, a lot of it I think has actually happened. One or two may have been a little bit more difficult. On the second one, that, you know, diplomacy, how does it look, it grows. It is not something which you know immediately and instantly. You practice hota hai, I mean you join the government, aapki training hoti hai, log aapko samjhate hain, anubhav hota hai, alag alag jagah jate hain, galtiyan ho jati hain kabhi kabhi, try and learn from it. You have good seniors who aapko mentor karte hain. So there are different ways by which this evolves. But I come back to it again. Agar interest hona. See, in my case, I started bachelor's in science. I moved to master's in political science and then other degrees in international relations. So, mujhe subject mein interest. Mujhe laga. And one of the reasons I joined, I sat for UPSC was I felt, bhai, padhne ke bajaye kam se kam, let me get some action also, kuch kar to le. Why should I read about other people doing anything? So, once you have that interest, you have that desire to keep improving yourself, this kind of ability in you or that tendency will actually grow with that. On this, you know, these two questions actually are somewhat similar. Kaha dominant hona chahiye, kaha helpful hona chahiye. Or you ask them, you know, when are you nice to people and when are you not so nice to people. It depends on the situation. I would say, as a person and as a country, most of the time we should actually be reasonable to people. We should explain to them, these are our interests, bhai, aap log samjhiye isko, hamare hit hai, we can find a way. So you try to reason with people. But if you, there will be situations when other person behaves very unreasonably. कि वो आपकी बात नहीं मानते या कुछ अग्रीमेंट था, कुछ सहमति थी, उसका उन्होंने उल्लंघन किया, या कभी कभी जो मेरे साथ हो जाता है लोग वो यू नो बिकॉज उनके यहाँ समय पुरानी आदतें हैं ना, तो देखता है ना कहीं अच्छा चलो उसको स्टूडियो बुला के लेट अस पुट हिम अंडर अंडर प्रेशर. नाउ व्हेन यू फील दैट द इंटेंट ऑफ द अदर पर्सन कि वो आपकी बात सुन ले, उसका लॉजिक उनको कहीं back me back. Then I think it's important to push back, because at that stage if you continue to be very nice, they don't take it as nice, they think it is weak. So where I would put your own question like this, you have to be nice until you feel they think nice is weak, it's for control. Now you have to be very clear, don't don't test us behind, beyond. And this way, you know, even sometimes people give some comment, you know, some assessment. Again, they are used to it. You know, for many years, things have been said about India, and nobody has replied from India. So they feel that we are free. Mein hota hai. You know, it's ki koi kimat nahi hai. You can do it and get away with it. So, when there is a pushback, then they also become a little bit more balanced about this. So that last question about redesigning the world. See, you know, in fact, I would give you a thought for your consideration. Just think, if partition of India had not happened, who our neighbors would have been? But that's a different issue. I mean, look, there are countries who with whom, you know, it's much easier for us for a variety of reasons to get along. I would not, you know, pick and choose your hair or head. You have to, as I say, neighbors are given by God. You have to deal with them the best that you can. So I will actually evade answering your question.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Gaurika, and it's my dream and goal to become an IFS officer. What I wanted to ask you is that what is, apart from your, amongst your multiple achievements, what is that one diplomatic achievement which is very close to your heart?
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Manchina and I'm aspiring to become a civil servant. So my question for you is, in present times we see there has been a large number of multilateral groupings that India has been a part of. So sometimes I wonder, there is a need to streamline our diplomatic energy so as to gain out the most of a few multilateral groupings, even in that cases.
Hello, sir. Sir, as our government's major agenda has always been regarding Bangladesh or India infiltrators, but today they have been too much penetrated into our society that even majority of unskilled labor you will find them. Isn't it a big border security failure, and what is today currently India's stance over it? Thank you.
Very good afternoon, sir. My name is Shri Babu and I'm a bachelor student of zoology honors. What is India's official stance on the string of pearls theory, which suggests China's strategic encirclement of India through ports and military installations in the Indian Ocean region?
Good morning, sir. I'm Sandeep from Tamil Nadu, and my question for you is, with a recent reference to Israel's ban on Al Jazeera, what is your viewpoint on media's influence on foreign policy?
First question, you know, of all the diplomatic issues with which I have been associated, what would I regard personally as with most satisfaction? It's a tough one, but I would say on balance, probably the creation and the growth of the Quad. Because I was first associated with it. We had tried in 2007, baat nahi bani, I was a middle-level person. 10 saal baad, I was foreign secretary, this time it worked. Then we wanted to upgrade, by that time I'd become foreign minister, we raised it to foreign minister, and of course finally it became now at prime minister's level. So when I see the importance of that issue and the difficulty, you know, the challenge of it, I would say all said and done, that's probably what I would pick as my number one. In terms of multilateral, कितने सारे multilateral हैं, streamline करना चाहिए. देखिए, remember this. You know, 10 years ago, we were economically, if you make a list, we were number 11 in the world. Okay. Today we are 5. हम कह रहे हैं अगले दो साल में we will be 3. A country of our size will get more and more involved with things. You would be surprised, Mama. We have Indian businesses in corner of South America, in Pacific, near New Zealand, near. So there is no part of the world today which India, and no issue with which India is not involved. So the day when we said, nahi, ye hamara issue nahi hai, ya ye bahut dur hai, that era is now over. Which few people will experience. So for me, in fact, the more we do, the better we are. Isko, I agree with you, isko manage karna hoga, iska tarika dhoondna hoga, iske liye procedures banane honge, but we should not lack ambition. This next Amrit Kaal is a period of ambition for it. You know, that is how, when we say, you know, we are saying, kam se kam number 2 to bane gaya, ho sakta aage bhi jaye. But that, if you don't have ambition, we will never make that issue. The Bangladesh infiltrators issue. You know, to a large extent, definitely border is more secure today. Now, what had happened before, I think, is a problem with which the country has to grapple with. I'm not sure there are any easy answers for it, but I know that there are places where this is a matter of concern. Then the issue about string of pearls. Well, you know, string of pearls was meant to describe that in the Indian Ocean, there were many Chinese bases which were coming up. At the time when they were coming up, ye 2007-2008 ki baat hai, people said, nahin, you know, you are exaggerating, actually in reality, ye nahin hoga, ye. But we have seen in 15 years from then, actually things have happened. That today there are bases in the Indian Ocean. There are presence of various in various forms of China in the Indian Ocean. So I think the early warnings of string of pearls, which was disregarded at that time, that I think was an error of that. That we have a challenge here, and I think we have a situation here which we should take very seriously. And last question, the media ki jo baat kar rahe hain. You named Al Jazeera, but I will only make one broader point and applicable to other outlets, outfits as well. Because we are becoming bigger, because we are doing better, because our progress in many ways will shape the rest of the world. The rest of the world is also trying to influence in different ways. They don't have to be governments who are influencing. Often these are done by media. If you look today, you know, at the kind of comments which are coming out of media, the kind of you know, attempts to shape opinion, to take it in different direction, I think all of these are very much part of an influence game that is going on. I think we should be aware of it. Globalized duniya mein. We should accept that these are realities, and we should prepare ourselves for it. And जैसे मैंने कहा, जहाँ जवाब देना है, हम जरूर जवाब देते हैं. जहाँ इसको ignore करना है या कहीं, you know, find ways of dealing with it, that also we can do. So once again, really thank you all very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for answering all the questions of our students. I hope everyone is filled with enthusiasm by paying attention to the words of such an eminent personality. As we move towards the culmination of our first episode of our annual lecture series, Abhigyan, and the last segment of flagship event, Atulya, I request our society president, who is a final year student of Hansraj College and also the president of Nishtha Society, Mr. Shumik Singh, for the vote of thanks and also mark the closure of this year's tenure.
A very warm and a farewell good afternoon to one and all present here. First and foremost, I would like to request our beloved principal ma'am to please convey a vote of thanks towards our honorable guest speaker, Dr. S. Jaishankar sir, with a token of appreciation. Please, ma'am. खुशियों भरी महफिल में आज अपनेपन का एहसास हुआ है खुशियों भरी महफिल में आज अपनेपन का एहसास हुआ है आपकी गरिमामयी उपस्थिति पाकर ये कार्यक्रम खास हुआ है ये कार्यक्रम खास हुआ है फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट इन द सीरीज ऑफ वोट ऑफ थैंक्स आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस माई वार्मेस्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड टुवर्ड्स डॉक्टर जयशंकर सर फॉर टेकिंग आउट टाइम फ्रॉम हिज बिजी स्केड्यूल एंड टू ग्रेस दिस जंक्चर सर्स प्रेजेंस हैड सर्टेनली एडेड the charismatic colors in the luster of this annual lecture series. So thank you so much, sir, for gracing the juncture of this annual lecture series. I would also like to take a moment to express my warmest gratitude towards our beloved principal ma'am, vice principal ma'am, our esteemed convener, all the teachers of Hansraj College and whole Hansraj family for their constant support in organizing these kinds of stupendous segment. Thank you so much, everyone. I would also like to take a moment to express my sincere thanks towards my core team, council, and all the members for their tireless effort for making this event a resounding success. Thank you, all the members. Thank you, core team. Thank you, council. My gratitude goes out to each one of you for coming in such a large number, for being patient listener. Certainly, your thought-provoking questions have made this session the most interactive one, and I hope you all will remember for your lifetime. Thank you so much, everyone. At last, with few lines, I would like to mark the closure of this session as well as of this annual flagship event named Atulya. इस उत्सव के प्रायोजन का वाचन करते हैं इस उत्सव के प्रायोजन का वाचन करते हैं दिल से एक दूसरे का अभिवादन करते हैं दिल से एक दूसरे का अभिवादन करते हैं ऐसे ही बूंद बूंद बनकर खुशी का सागर बनाते रहें ऐसे ही बूंद बूंद बनकर खुशी का सागर बनाते रहें इसी दुआ के साथ हम कार्यक्रम का समापन करते हैं इसी दुआ के साथ हम कार्यक्रम का समापन करते हैं